Good morning, church. Oh, you're here. I hear the joyful sounds already. Good morning. Good morning. It's wonderful to be here at SunCoast MCC, where we teach and practice truth, trust, and transformation. So will you wave to our online folks who are worshiping with us today? Good morning, everyone. Let us know where you are worshiping from, and check in with us. And if you have any special prayer requests, let us know. And if there's more than one of you worshiping, let us know how many folks are in your worship party this morning. So today is February 5th, and we begin our celebration of Black History Month. And we honor, you see our banner as you came in this morning, of facts about Black history in Florida. In Florida. I'm not from Florida, so there was a lot I did not know about Florida. Did you know that Jonathan Clark Gibbs, in 1868, was the first African-American cabinet member in the state of Florida? He was Secretary of State, and he's the person responsible for starting public education in the state of Florida. Amen. And we have a lot to be concerned about public education in Florida these days. And so in the spirit of Jonathan Clark Gibbs, we will continue on. We also want to say a wonderful, warm hello and welcome back to Reverend Vicki Miller. Stand up. Yeah. See, you showed up on the right day. You got up this morning for a good reason. Amen. So you got up for another good reason, and that is to hear our guest, and I'll introduce her more a little bit later. But will you welcome Dr. April Glasco? We are so glad you're worshiping with us today. If you're new with us, did you get a welcome packet this morning? Did you get a welcome? No? Okay. Ushers, we need a welcome packet down front here. Okay, down here. And we're so glad to welcome you in worship today. God bless you as we hear our announcements.
Good morning. Good morning. We're looking for a gently, are you looking for a gently used solid oak desk? We would love to offer this to a member or friend of the church before advertising to the public. It is approximately 6 feet by four. It can be yours for a $150 donation to the church. You will need to arrange to pick it up. Contact the church if you would like to come and take a look of it. We will advertise to the public after a couple of weeks, so don't delay. Monday night, February 6th, is the final night of VICA Winter Series. If you have any questions, see Reverend Jean. Next Sunday is Chaps and Pillar Sundays. Please consider giving an extra amount to the mortgage fund and bringing in donations of food and hygiene items to support the work of CHAPS. February 14th, Jay Pinnell will be holding the first advocacy group meeting at 1 p.m. You can join in person or virtually. Want to participate in the virtual Social Justice Book Club? They will be reading the book Invention of Wings by Susan Monk Kidd. See Cindy Duranko if you need a book. Now, Reverend Nancy will help us celebrate our birthdays and anniversaries. Okay.
All right, birthdays. If you have a birthday this month, will you please rise as you're able? Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Kings and queens and princes too, gonna wish the best of luck to you. So wish day, wash day, birthday, happy birthday to you.
And happy anniversary to Connie and Linda. Let's sing it. Happy anniversary to you.
Happy anniversary to you.
Happy anniversary, dear
Connie and Linda. Happy anniversary to you.
All right. We have two more anniversaries for Sunday. Reverend Jean, will you please stand up. It's Reverend Gene's 5th anniversary of his ordination. Will you give him a... Yes, I'm so glad Reverend Vicki could be here today and to wish you happy anniversary. And also, last Sunday, we missed it, but here it is Reverend Rick's very first anniversary as our assistant pastor. Will you give him a great big hand? Come on. Thank you, dear. I just want to say, how delightful it has been. I want you to know, Reverend Rick, that Reverend Vicki, when she knew she was retiring, the first thing she said to me is, "You ought to ask Rick to come on board." And she was right. As always, she was right. And so we're so delighted. I'm so delighted and thrilled and grateful that you and Mike are both here. Thank you so much. God bless you.
Last but pretty exciting, the social event team is scheduling a potluck on February 19th after worship to celebrate our 28th anniversary. Remembering our goal of 80 plus in person and 40 plus virtually worshiping with us to celebrate our anniversary. Finally, masks are optional for worship and indoor events. Just a reminder that the flu and cold season is here, and we encourage everyone to get their flu shots and COVID boosters. Please remember to stay at home if you are sick. This is for the health and safety of all. Check out the website and the weekly Staying Connected for additional information on ways to stay involved. Now, let's take a minute to greet each other safely. Please rise. And on the count of three, open your arms wide and extend a warm welcome to all joining us in person and online. One, two, three.
And people will find a way. Give light, and people will find a way. Give light, and people will find a way. People will find a way, I do believe.
Give hope.
Give hope. Will find a way. Give hope, and people will find a way. Give hope, and people will find a way. People will find a way, I do believe.
Give love.
And people will find a way. Give light, and people will find a way. People will find a way, I do believe. People will find a way, I do believe.
Oh God, you are our healer. Let us claim that today. Healing for those who have nowhere to turn to today. For those who are forgotten.
For refugees and struggling families.
You call us to be healers. In your name, let us claim that power today.
Claim healing for racism, for systemic injustice, for abuse of power.
It is not just individuals and systems that need healing, but attitudes and beliefs.
Let us
healing for all. Difference from messages that say your powers change the world. As we worship today, inspire us to be your love and light in a world that continues to need healing and help. Through Jesus Christ we pray. Amen.
Good morning. Please stand as you're able and join us in singing God is Here.
A sweet anointing in this sanctuary. There is a stillness in the atmosphere. Come and lay down the burdens you have carried, for in this sanctuary God is here. There is a sweet anointing in this sanctuary. There is a stillness in the atmosphere. Come and lay down the burdens you have carried, for in this sanctuary God is here. God is here, God is here, to break the yoke and lift the heavy burden.
God is here, God is here,
to heal the heart and bless the broken.
And lay down
the burdens you have carried, for in the sanctuary God is here. God is here. God is here to break the yoke and lift the heavy burden. God is here. God is here. And bless the broken.
Come and lay down the burdens you have carried, for in this sanctuary God is here.
Amen. May be seated. Amen. Amen.
Hear these sacred words of the prophet Isaiah. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Almighty, and my right is disregarded by my God? Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Almighty is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. God does not grow faint or weary. God's understanding is unsearchable. The Almighty gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for our God shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Your word is a lamp to our feet. Amen.
Please rise as you are able for the reading of the Gospel according to Mark. Mark 1, verses 29 through 39. As soon as they left the synagogue, they entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Now Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with a fever, and they told him about her at once. He came and took her by the hand and lifted her up. Then the fever left her, and she began to serve them. That evening at sundown, they brought to him all who were sick or possessed with demons, and the whole city was gathered around the door. And he cured many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons. And he would not permit the demons to speak because they knew him. In the morning, while it was still very dark, he got up and went out to a deserted place, and there he prayed. And Simon and his companions hunted for him. When they found him, they said to him, "Everyone is searching for you." He answered, "Let us go on to the neighboring towns, so that I may proclaim the message there also, for that is what I came out to do." And he went throughout Galilee, proclaiming the message in their synagogues and casting out demons. The word of God for us, the people of God. Amen.
Gathering song, Over My Head.
Head. I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music in the air. There must be a God. Over my head, I hear singing in the air. Over my head, I hear singing in the air. Over my head, I hear singing in the air.
Must be a God somewhere. We have a wonderful opportunity here this morning at Suncoast. Dr. April Glasco is the founder and CEO of Second Chance Last Opportunity Incorporated in Sarasota, Florida for 33 years. She has served as a corrections officer, a juvenile detention caseworker, but today she serves the wider community in this amazing way. Her commitments to her clients is unwavering. She saw tremendous need in her community and devised a plan to meet that need. Instead of handing out charity, April is on the streets looking for, finding, and helping people by providing respect, counseling, training, and high expectations. Her goal is to give people the skills and confidence that will enable them to make positive choices and build a better future for themselves and their family. Excuse me. The positive effect Dr. Glasgow and her organization has had on people of Newtown is remarkable, and there's all kinds of awards she's received in our communities, and well-deserved. Dr. Glasco empowers individuals from all walks of life to gain a sense of self-worth, self-esteem, and confidence through teaching, counseling, interpersonal workshops, seminars, and speaking engagements. She holds a Doctor of Divinity degree and a Master's in Mental Health Counseling, is a published author, has won international awards, and is a wonderful preacher. And I'm proud to say, as a friend and colleague and someone I've admired a long time, and who I'm proud to say is one of our community partners for Suncoast MCC, will you welcome Dr. April?
We are here by the womb inside. We are here by the womb.
Oh, yes, sir.
Am I saved? Lord, Lord, Lord,
You all I need. You all I need. You all I need. Somebody say yes, Lord. Somebody say yes, Lord. Somebody say yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes! 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 Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah! 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 Yes, Lord! Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. He's here right now. He's here right now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I am so glad to be here. Hallelujah. Praise God. I am so honored. Thank you, Reverend Nancy. This is a privilege to be here. And I love the Lord. I guess you can tell. I love him so much. Thank you, Jesus. And just saying that I am healed. You are healed. Past tense. Whatever you was going through is already done. It's already done. You are healed. You have been delivered. And you have been set free. And it's already done. So why are you worrying about it? Stop worrying about it. Why are you pacing the floor? Why are you up late at night? It's already done. God already have it under control. So what are you worrying about it for? Amen. There's a scripture in the Bible, a parable that Jesus heals the man that went to the pool. And see, he was stuck for 38 years. My question to you is, are you stuck? If you are stuck, how long you been stuck? Because right now, today, I want you to know that you don't have to be stuck no more. Because it's already done. Praise God. John, the 5th chapter. It says, for an angel went down a certain season into the pool and troubled the water. Whosoever then first after the troubling of the water stepped in and made whole of whatever condition, situation, problem. Now in the Bible it says disease. I'm just going to add whatever the situation, the problem, what's been holding you hostage for a very long time. And a certain man was there. Today you are here. Today I'm here. And he has been in this condition for 38 years. Again, how long you been in your condition? And how long do you plan on staying there? When Jesus saw him lie and knew that he had been there, see, Jesus already knows. He already knows how long you've been there. He knows more about you than you know about yourself. How long, he knew how long he was there. And what he did, would you like to be made whole? Would you like today to let go and let God take over the situation? Because I don't believe you can continue with this situation after today's service and just walk out that door and say, hey, I'm going to take it with me. Oh, no, this is it. This is final. So whatever you got going on right now, somebody said, let it go. Look to your neighbor and say, let it go. Look behind you and say, let it go. Say it a little louder. I'm going to let it go. Jesus. Yes, yes, yes. And the man answered, said, yes. But he made a complaint. Every time the water was troubled, somebody stepped before him. I believe that was just an excuse. But the Lord already know our excuses, because what he did for us is, when he died with all the excuses. So why do you carry the excuse over and over again of something he already healed you from? He healed you from that. He delivered you from that, but yet you carry it over and over and over and over again. And he said, I can't deal with it. You're not supposed to deal with it. Turn it over to him. Praise God. He said, nobody can put me in this pool. Somebody always stepped down before me. But what Jesus said, would you like to be made whole? He didn't want to hear those excuses. And somehow we come up with the excuse, I can't. It's not the time. Nobody won't let me. What kind of excuse is that? When you already know who he is, what he already done for you, and what you can see that he has blessed you over and over and over again. So what the Lord then told him, rise, take up your bed, and walk. How much faith do you have within yourself to say, Lord, I'll do it. Lord, I'll do it. So let me see you rise quickly. You got to rise. You got to move quick. You can't take your time. When he speak, you move. So you can immediately be healed and set free. So let's try this again. Y'all took your time. There's no excuse when the Lord's moving. Ah, he got it. Oh, somebody missed it again. I didn't even have to say rise. There's no excuse when the Lord is moving in this place. He's setting you free right now. Whatever condition and situation that you felt in your heart before you when you walked in, you shouldn't have nothing holding you back. Thank you, Jesus. He made you whole. He delivered you. He set you free. Take all the excuses and say, Lord, you got this. And devil, you're a liar. Yeah. Ah, yes, sir. Once he took up his bed, he walked. What's stopping you from walking into your blessing? All it takes for you to say, Lord, I believe. Faith as a mustard seed, I believe. I believe is already done. And then what you do is go where he tells you to go. Open your mouth and speak how he wants you to speak. Do what he wants you to do. And walk where he wants you to walk. Now, is that hard to do? When he wants you to move, you're supposed to do what? When he wants you to speak, he wants you to do what? When he wants you to walk, he wants you to do what? There you go. Hi, yes, sir. Thank you, Jesus. You got to do what he wants you to do. You don't do what you need to do, want to do, and see how fit it will be for you. Oh, my God, that was good. I'll take that one. If I had a use for a subject, step in, wait until he moves you. Step in, wait until he moves you. We like to step in and keep moving and do what we want to do. And then when we get in a situation, Lord, I need your help. Help me, Lord, right now. But he already warned you, just wait. Wait on me and see the salvation of the Lord. We are so anxious. We want to move so quick. We want to do it. We think we're in control. But But we're never in control. He created each one of us in his own image. What makes you think that you could do what you want to do? Think about that one. Step in and do what?
Faith.
Step in and do what?
Faith.
One more time. Step in and do what?
Wait.
Wait on the Lord. You can't do nothing anyway. When you wake up in the morning, he wakes us up. Sometimes we have the alarm clock. But the awesome thing about it, he wakes us up right on time. He's a timely, orderly God. He doesn't want us to hurt. He don't want us to be in so much of a mess. And he wants to heal and deliver and see us free. A free mind. A free heart to love everyone. It doesn't matter what another person say or do. What matters is how you respond. How you respond. One ugly person doesn't make another person ugly with them. That was good. Two ugly people can't do nothing but look at each other ugly. So we're arguing, bickering, fussing, and fighting, and no one hears what neither one is saying. And how far do we think we can go with that? Not far. So when you stop and think about the goodness of Jesus and all he have done for you, why would you want to argue with someone that's already out of control, that's trying to get you out of control with them? Do that make sense?
Yes.
Stop and see what they're doing. Miserable people want company. Oh, Jesus. Yes, sir. And if you give them that, you just gave them exactly what they wanted. Am I right?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So when you step back and take a pause, it doesn't mean that you have to do anything. In Psalms 23, when they said, Jesus said, the enemy came at the table. Psalms 23, he prepared a table. He prepared a table, right? Before who? The enemies, right? He prepared the table for the enemies, but he never offered the enemies anything. Why are you continuing offering your enemies everything? Do you understand what I just said? A conversation, which you already know what they're going to say. The Lord healed you, E.D., from all that mess that he brought you out of. But yet you want to step back in it.
Yes, sir.
And still have the conversation with the person that you knew was your enemy.
Oh, my God.
Why would you want to go back in that situation then turn around and say, Lord, heal me again? Listen. So we have this woman empowerment class. And I asked a question about Humpty Dumpty. How many times Humpty Dumpty fell off the wall? How many times? No. Humpty Dumpty fell off the wall. At the end of Humpty Dumpty, it said again. Think about it. It said again, right? Am I right or wrong? Again. He fell off the wall again. How many times Humpty Dumpty fell off the wall? We don't know how many times. until Humpty Dumpty decided I'm tired of falling off the wall. So how many times have you fell off of a situation and got back in it again? Ooh, I'm stepping on some toes. It's all right. It's all right. And again, and again, and again, until you decide to get it right. Right? And I said, I had enough of this. Well, you had enough of it the first time, the second time, and the third time. But you did it again. So who stops? The Lord stopped you from doing it again. Because you had to pray, Lord, help me. And he had to put something in your way to block you from going in that direction. And it turns around, he had to heal you from keep going over and over again in a situation that you kept asking, Lord, help me. Lord, help me. But you kept stepping in it over and over again until he says, you can't keep, my child, listen to me. You can't keep going in this situation and then you keep asking me to help you. Then you hear that soft voice. Don't you go down there again. Don't you go down there again. And you hear it. Or the phone ring to keep you from going down there. Or you get a knock on the door. That's your sign that said, I bet not go down that way again. Do you ignore the sign or you just keep on going until you decide, who are you? Who are you? Don't ask if you're not willing to turn yourself around. Because there's consequences behind your behavior. Don't blame the enemy what they keep doing to you if you keep going down the same path and doing the same thing with the enemy. That makes sense? So think before you do, and then when it's all over and said and done, say, Lord, I thank you. You must say, I thank you. He delivered you from something that you couldn't stop doing. Thank you, Lord. Thank you again, Lord. Thank you again, Lord. He hears you. He already knows your heart. He put you through the test so you'll have a testimonial. So you can share with your friends or share with the pastor and share with those that come and you meet and greet. Man, I went down that path again. And I thought I wouldn't do it again. And I tried it 12 more times. Not 38, but 12 more times. Until I decided I'm not going to do it no more. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Peter, 1 Peter 5 and 10, it says, and after you have suffered a little while, now you're suffering. If you see yourself sleepless nights, talking to yourself, tossing and turning, on the phone, talking to everybody about the same situation that you said you wasn't going to do, you are putting something on yourself. The God of all grace will let you go through that because obedience is better than a sacrifice. But if you want to be disobedient to God, there's consequences. Who he has called you to, his eternal glory in Christ, will himself restore, confirm, strengthen, and establish. He can restore you. He can strengthen you. He will establish your footsteps if you let him. If you let him. Lean not on your own understanding. Trust God before you move and take another step. He already knows the plans for you. He knows your future. He know how much you can bear. Praise God. Praise God. If you receive him and have that personal relationship with him, it will help you along the way that you don't have to struggle, suffer, come up with plans of your own, strategies, and negotiate of what you think you should do. But if you trust God, he will direct your path. And what path are you on? His path. You have no path until you have this personal relationship with him. Who are you? We're nothing without him. We all trust him for who he is. For he died upon the cross that we all may have the right to the tree of life. It doesn't matter how old or how young. The color of your skin. It doesn't matter whether you're rich or poor. He's the same God for everyone. Everyone. And when you continue trusting him, the true love that comes from your heart, you love everyone unconditionally. Like Reverend Nancy loves me. Unconditionally. Like I love Reverend Nancy. And each one of us love each other unconditionally. When you hurt, everyone should hurt. When you're sad, we should all be sad. We are there for each other. Am I right or wrong? So we have to do what's right. Live what's right. Say what's right. Live accordingly to God's purpose. Amen? And then we don't have to worry about our hearts being in trouble when we know we're doing right. Where someone have to go and say, let not my heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house. There are many mansions, huh? Yes, sir. And each one of us will be in a mansion, huh? Yes, sir. There's no rich people, poor people, black people, white people, no people. It doesn't have no signs up there when you get to heaven. Do, is it? There's nothing. Amen, amen. It doesn't matter. Huh? Yes, sir. We're all trying to get to heaven. And not to hell. Amen? Seek him first, the kingdom of God, and his righteousness. And all these things will be added unto us. To you, to us, to anyone that seeks him. The first thing you have to do is what? Seek. If you ain't seeking, You're looking in the wrong places and trying to find something that will benefit you. That's not how it works. It doesn't work that way. God is there all the time. He will never leave you nor forsake you. He's a God with a second chance, a third chance, a fourth chance. And I know each one of us has some chances. He keep giving us chances after chances after chances after chances and over again. And it's like he done did it again. Yes, he done did it again. In Isaiah 40 and 31, but they who wait for the Lord. The key word is wait. For the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not what? He healed you. Why should you want to faint? He delivered you. He have given you strength. Why would you want to give up? He have opened doors for you. He have showed you, demonstrated over and over again, why walk away from a God that keep giving you a second chance? Half of the time you didn't deserve the first chance. But he does it for you because he loves you. Hallelujah. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. And do not lean on your own understanding. What happens when you lean on your own understanding? Everything goes crazy. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall strengthen what? He shall make straight your path. God is awesome, powerful. He delivered you. He set you free. You are healed by him. When they pierced him in the side, he died for us all. When they crucified him, we were all here. Still alive by the grace of God. Jesus is everything to you. Amen.
Today, because we trust in God, and we're gonna do our offertory for our song of reflection.
We're
and our song
flip.
Of reflection for our offertory. So we're gonna flip it. So this is if I can help somebody.
All right.
And I just have to give a starting pitch for this, which is fabulous.
If I can help somebody as I pass along, if I can help somebody with a word or song, if I can show somebody how they're traveling wrong, then my living shall not be in vain. Then my living shall not be in vain. Then my living shall not be in vain. If I can help somebody as I pass along, then my living shall not be in vain. If I can do my duty as a good one ought, if I can bring back beauty to a world abroad, if I can spread love's message as our good God taught, then my living shall not be in vain. Then my living shall not be in vain. The pass along, then my living shall not be in vain. Christ be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light,
shine in your church, gather today.
Christ be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in your church gathered today.
As we go before God in prayer this morning, our focus today is on healing. David, if you'll just play a little something underneath, please. If you're here today and you have a special need, especially a need of healing, whether it be in mind, body, or spirit, whether it be in your emotions, whatever it is, I believe the healer is here today, able to touch us and to heal us, to strengthen us, to lift us up, to encourage us, to keep moving step by step, trusting, believing that God has promised to never leave us nor forsake us, and that God is able to help us and to heal us. And so I invite you to bow your heads and hearts with me as we pray together. Loving, gracious God, Jesus, healer of all, we speak healing in this moment. For every life situation, every circumstance, every dis-ease, whether it be physically, emotionally, mentally, whatever infirmity it is that we bear, that we carry today, we trust you for healing and strength, for wholeness in mind, body, and spirit, Almighty God. God, we pray for those online as they watch today, the needs that they represent as well. We speak that same healing over them. You paid a great price, oh God, through Jesus Christ. And we receive those healings that we seek today. And we trust you for them. We pray for those we know and love. We pray for our community, for our state, for our country, for our world, oh God, that you would heal us all, strengthen us. We give you thanks and we give you praise. And April, if I could call you forward, we'd like to pray over you. Congregation, if I can invite you to rise as you are able and just send some of that positive prayer energy toward April today. God, we thank you for this, your servant. We thank you for the call that you have on her life to make a difference in the lives of so many people. We speak your continued touch and your anointing over her today, Almighty God. Continue to give her the words to speak, the actions to take, the wisdom well beyond her experience even, O God, to deal with those that she deals with each and every day. May compassion, may your love all well up from her and flow out to those to whom she ministers day by day. May their lives be touched. May their lives be enhanced by her ministry to them, and may her light continue to shine to all. We thank you. We speak it as done. In Jesus' name, amen. And now let us all pray together that prayer that Jesus taught us together, saying, Our heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Christ be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in your church, gather today.
Amen. You may be seated. Today we will take two offerings. The first offering is your tithes and offerings for the support of this church. We are so grateful for your faithfulness. We are so grateful for all of the healing that you have brought to this community and to so many. I want you to feel that today, that this has been a place of healing for almost 28 years. Think about that, about how much healing and how much healing still has to be done. Today we want to support our community partner, Second Chance, and Dr. April in love for what they do for people whose lives we may not touch, but who we can touch in a deeper way. It's our response to God's grace and God's healing today. So please give as giving to our God for our first and our second offering today. Thank you.
How great thou art,
how great thou art,
then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art, holy, holy, are you Lord God, almighty.
Just go ahead and stay risen as you are. God, we offer these gifts to you out of our love for you and for your church and for the work of your realm here in this community and beyond. Bless gift and giver in your many names. Amen. You may be seated.
If you are watching online, I invite you to gather your bread and juice as we prepare for communion. For those of you gathered here, I invite you to retrieve your communion packet. If you did not receive a packet, please raise your hand for an usher. There are two... Reverend Vicky, of all people. We love you, Reverend Vicky. There are two seals, one for the bread and one for the juice. Unseal the top seal and wait until instructed for us to consume together.
The Holy One be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to our God.
Let us give thanks to our God.
It is right to give our God thanks.
Let us pray. Loving God, we sing the song, "There is a balm in Gilead to make the wounded whole." And we know that your presence, especially at this table, is that balm. Is that healing power we need to live and thrive. Let us trust and live as though nothing is beyond your capacity to heal in our bodies, minds, spirits, and in our families, our churches, our communities, our state, our country, our world. Let healing flow from this table, in and through us and beyond us, even to the power structures and systems that oppress and destroy. Strengthen us as we journey, as we learn and relearn the stories of Jesus. Help us reconnect to you and be filled with the healing light of your divine and holy presence as we sing together.
For everyone born, a place at the table. For everyone born, clean water and bread. A shelter, a place, a safe place for growing. For everyone born, a star overhead. And God will delight when we are creators of justice and joy. Yes, God will delight when we are creators of justice.
thanks, O God, for the mighty sweep of your love that embraces all people and all nations. Pour out your calling, especially on MCC churches worldwide. Raise up healers and leaders who will grow your church and witness to the gospel that is deep and wide, that includes all. On the night before he died, rather when he surrendered himself for the life of the world, he was with his friends in the upper room. He took bread, he gave thanks. He broke the bread and gave it to his friends, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body. Whenever you do this, remember me."
And likewise, after supper, as was their custom, Jesus took the cup. He lifted it up, he blessed it, thanked God for it, and he gave it to the disciples, explaining to them, "This is my love, poured out for you and for all people. Take and drink deeply of my love. And every time you drink of it, remember me." And so this morning, with faith and hope as your people, we proclaim together that Christ will come again. Let us pray. Bless this meal that we will share together today. May the same spirit of love that hovered over those first disciples hover over us as we embrace this table today. May we follow the same passion and commitment. In Jesus' name, amen.
At all MCC churches around the world, we welcome everyone to the table, regardless of where you are on your life journey. I enjoyed Doctor's message. There is hope for everyone when you're at the bottom of the pit. The only way to go is to look up and follow the light, which is Jesus. Everyone is worthy to come to the table. Even all, not sinners. Christ died for our sins. So again, I would ask, if you did not receive a communion packet, you are all welcome to the table. These are God's gifts for us, God's people. Whether you are participating from home or gathered here, please consume now the bread and juice. And as we do so, may we experience God's love and blessing.
For everyone born a place at the table, for everyone born clean water and bread, a shelter, a space, a safe place for growing, for everyone born a star overhead. And God will delight when we are creators of justice and joy. Yes, God will delight when we are creators of justice. Justice and joy.
Let us pray. God, this meal we shared it together is a remembrance of your grace in sending Jesus and your radical embrace of all people. May we be known by the healing light we shine into the world. For it is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Please rise for our closing song, Glory, Glory, Hallelujah.
Glory, glory, hallelujah.
Lord, we just thank you for what you have done, and thank you for showing up and showing out. All right. Lord, be with us, each one of us, as we leave here and depart and go our separate ways. We know that we have done what you asked us to do. In Jesus' name, amen.